हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज़ आरोही एंड वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल कोड विद आरोही। सो गाइज, इन माय टुडेज वीडियो आई विल शो यू हाउ टू इम्प्लीमेंट सिंगल शॉट डिटेक्टर एल्गोरिदम ऑन योर कस्टम डेटा सेट। सो द डेटा सेट ऑन विच आई एम वर्किंग इज हेडफोन एंड ईयरफोन क्लास। सो दीज आर द टू क्लासेज ऑन विच आई वॉन्ट टू वर्क। आई वॉन्ट टू बिल्ड अ कस्टम ऑब्जेक्ट डिटेक्टर फॉर दीज टू क्लासेज, ओके, हेडफोन एंड ईयरफोन। सो गाइज, फॉर दिस फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट मी टेल यू द एनवायरमेंट विच आई एम यूजिंग। सो आई एम यूजिंग पाइथन 3.6.8, आई एम यूजिंग कूडा 10.0, ओके। वाई एम यूजिंग कूडा 10.0 बिकॉज आई एम यूजिंग टेंसरफ्लो जीपीयू 1.15.0, राइट। सो विद दिस टेंसरफ्लो जीपीयू वर्जन यू नीड कूडा 10.0, ओके। सो यू हैव टू सी विच वर्जन ऑफ टेंसरफ्लो यू आर यूजिंग एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट यू हैव टू चूज योर कूडा वर्जन, ओके। एंड if you are choosing CUDA 10.0, so then you have to choose a specific version of CUDNN which you need to install CUDNN also, okay. So this is the environment which I'm using. So now see, the data set, the format of the data set which we are going to use in our today class for custom object detector, that format would be in the format of Pascal Walk dataset. So basically what you need to do is, first of all, obviously we need to prepare our dataset in the format which our algorithm accepts, right? So which format we want for our today's class, the format of our dataset should be in the form of Pascal Walk dataset, right? So in Pascal Walk dataset, what happens is they have their annotations in the form of XML files. So this is the example of one XML file. We need one XML file for one image. So let's suppose this is the image. For this image, this is the XML file which you will have, okay. So let's say if you have 10 images, so you need 10 separate XML files for each of the image which will store the annotation detail of every particular image, okay. So now let me show you the data set first of all. So the data set is this data set. See guys, I'm working on very small data set because our main motive is to understand the concept here, right? So I'm not focusing on accuracy right now. I'm just want to implement this algorithm and I want to show you the results. So that's why I'm using 40 images. But obviously if you want to work on real applications, there obviously you need lots of data, right? So these are the 40 images and 20 images I have of headphone class, because what we are doing is we are building custom object detector for two classes. One is headphone and other one is earphone. So I have 20 images for headphone class and 20 images for earphone class, okay. Now what you need to do is just see this folder. In this folder I have these many folders and files. First of all, to implement today's code, you need to, okay, let me open this. Yeah, so I have given the GitHub link in the description section. You can get this particular GitHub repo from there. So this is the GitHub repo which I'm using for my today's class, okay. So these are the folders and these are the files which you need to execute SSD model, okay. And guys, basically what I have done is I'm following this GitHub repo, okay. So I took some code from this particular GitHub repo and I have made few changes. I have, you know, deleted few files, I have made modifications in few files, but the main code is I picked that code from here and after that I have done few modification and then I have prepared my own GitHub repo. This is the GitHub repo and the link is given in description section. First of all, the very first thing is you need to clone this GitHub repo, okay. So once you clone this GitHub repo, you'll get all these folders and files. Now you can see here we have one folder with the name of Walk 2007. In this folder, now let me show you what you need to do in this folder. Let me open this folder. Under this Walk 2007 folder, you need to create three folders with the exact same names, okay. Annotations, image sets and JPEG images. You need exact same names. Okay. Under JPG images, open it. You have to put all the images which you have, right? This is the data set on which you want to build your custom object detector. So you have to put all your images in this particular folder under VOC 2007. Under JPG images, over here put all your images, and you have to put all your annotations file, right? Every image have one annotation file which will have the bounding box detail of this particular image. So all those annotations you have to store in this annotations folder. Okay, so we have 40 annotation files. Why we have 40 annotation file? Because we have 40 images in our JPG images data set. Okay, now the question over here is, if you already have your data set in a Pascal Vogue data set format, that's really good. But if you don't have data set in the Pascal Vogue format and you just downloaded few images, right? See, what you can do is, let's say you want to build a custom object detector for cars and trucks, right? And you don't have images with you. Just download some images from internet, right? Put those images in this JPEG IMG folder, right? Let's say you have 40 images of 20 images of cars and 20 images of trucks over here, and you have downloaded those images from internet. After that, you have to perform annotation on it, right? And for annotation, there are various tools, but you can use label IMG tool. Okay, so how you can use that label IMG tool? Let me show you. There are only two steps. Just write this command. This command will install the label IMG tool, and this command will open the label IMG tool. Okay, let me show you. So I have already installed it. So what I'll do is, I'll just copy this thing and let's paste it over here. Just give me a second. So this is how you can open label IMG tool. And from here, open directory, just go to open directory and then select the folder where you have your images. So our images in this folder, select this like this. Okay, so now you can see the very, I have already performed the annotation, so that's why you can see this annotation like this. Now over here, you have to choose this Pascal Vogue. Okay, so using this label IMG tool, you can, you know, annotate your images in YOLO format also. But before before doing annotation, just take care, like, you are working on this Pascal Vogue, because strictly we need data set in this format. So just check if this is Pascal Vogue over here, then click on this create rect box. You'll get this kind of rectangle. Plot it like this. Let's say you want to give a name headphone, right? Headphone, and then do OK. Once you do OK, then save it from here. So I'm not performing this task because I have already done. So this is how you need to do. Just give the label every time you plot a bounding box, assign label to it. After that, click on save, because once you click on save, then only the XML file will get saved. And you can over here, you can change the directory where you want to save the annotation files. You can fix that directory name from here, right? So this is how you can use this label IMG tool. Okay, so once you annotate all your images, what will happen? Now you have two folders. In JPG folder, you have all the images, and in annotation folder, you have all your annotation files which are in XML format. And let me open one XML file and show you. So this is my XML file for the image with this name. We have one image with this name, and this is the annotation file for it. So this is how you will get two things. Now let's talk about this third folder, which is image sets. Now what this image sets is, see, under this image set you need two text file, right? One is train.txt and one is test.txt. These two files will contain the data. Train.txt will contain like how many samples we are using for training, and test.txt is responsible for testing. Okay, so these files are basically a train test split. We are performing a train test split. Now how we are performing this train and test split? So for that we have a code. Okay, so that code is let's see from here. So split train test, right? And you can see the same files we have, split train test. Okay, you can open this file and here you can see this is the code, right? So what I'm doing is, this is the folder where all our images are present right now, and I want to split the data by this 10%, and this is my train.txt file and this is the test.txt file. I want to create these two files at this particular location. We want to create an image set folder, right, which is in Vogue 2007 folder. So at this particular location I want to create these two files, and once you execute this whole code, train.txt and test.txt will get generated under this image sets variable folder. Okay, now let's open this train.txt file and see how many samples we have. So we have we'll use these samples for training our algorithm, and in test.txt we have these three samples because we have 40 images. Out of 40 images, we, after splitting our data, we have three images for testing purpose and 37 images we are using for training purpose. So guys, right? So first of all, this is the important task. Till now we have learned how to prepare data set for SSD when you want to work on custom data set. All right, okay. So now the next step is, once your data is prepared and everything is there in Vogue 2007 folder, now the next thing is you have to convert your XML files, the annotation files which are in XML format, you have to convert those annotation files in TF records. So you can see we have one folder over here, TF records. Open this folder. So what we are doing is, you can see that we have 40 different TF record files, right? So what we did is, we basically converted our XML annotation files into TF record because our algorithm will accept the data in the format of TF records. Okay, so how we converted our data into TF record now? So for that we have this script, XML to TF record conversion. Let's open the script and see what is there in it. So guys, when you will open it, so you have to make few changes as per your data set. So in my data set, so we have one background class. So this is what you need to do for background class. And I have two classes. One is headphone class and other one is earphone class, right? This is how, let's say if you have three classes and some other three classes, you have to mention over here like this. And over here you can see, remember this JPG images folder, here we have all our images, and under this annotation folder we have all our XML annotation files, and these are our classes, our custom classes. Okay, so you have to make changes over here, right? In which file I'm working right now? XML to TF record conversions. So these are the first changes you have to make. All right, so once you make the changes, what you have to do is just actually open this code and let me run it and show you how to run it. So basically what I'm doing is, I'm running this code in Anaconda. So let me open Anaconda, let me deactivate this base environment first of all. Okay, now let's go in D drive because my code is in D drive. Now I want to activate the environment in which I'm working. So first of all, let's see what all environments I have. So the environment which I have created for this SSD is this SSD env-gpu. Let's activate it. Conda activate SSD env-gpu. So now we have activated our environment. Now let's go into the folder where our code is. So my code is here. CD. Now we have entered in the folder. Now we want to execute this particular file, right? So just write python space xml that file name and enter. Once you perform, I'm not performing this because I have already performed this code, so I'm just showing you the way how to perform, right? Now after writing this, just press enter. Once you press enter, what will happen is under this tf records folder you will see all the 40 TF records separate files, right? So over here you have to check your TF record files should be equal to your XML files. Okay, so now we have converted our data into TF records. So now next step is, okay, we have done this part, we have converted our data into TF records. Now the next step is, okay, the very important step, which is go inside this datasets folder. Inside this dataset folder you will have one file with the name of this Pascal Vogue underscore 2007.py. open this file. Here we will do lots of changes as per our dataset, okay, and you have to do these changes very carefully. Just come to this line number 34. Here you can see train statistics. Simply means here you have to tell your algorithm how many images you are using for training, and in those images how many time which particular object is occurring. Okay, how many images and how many time that particular object is occurring. So none 0 0, that simply means background images is 0. We have 0 images of background and we have 0 objects of background class. Headphone 19. So we have 19, guys. Remember, for training, why I'm writing 19 over here, because we have divided our data into train and test plate, and we have, out of those 40 images we have 37 images for training now. So out of those 37 images, 19 images belongs to headphone class and 18 images belongs to earphone class, and 20 times headphone object is occurring in those 19 images, and 22 times earphone object is occurring in earphone class. Okay, so this is, you have done the train statistics. Over here you have to mention the values as per your dataset, obviously, right? And then we have this test statistics. Again, your test data set, how many images we have in our test data set? 3 images. So out of those 3 images, 1 image belongs to headphone class and 2 images belongs to earphone class, and we have earphone object 2 time and we have headphone object 1 time. So this is our test statistics. After that, here we have to define our split size. So how many images we have in train? 37, and we have 3 images for test. Okay, and over here inside this train we are providing the train statistics which we have mentioned here, and inside the this is test is a key, and over here we are providing this value over here, right? So you have to make these changes, rest of the file would be same. And yes, over here number of classes, how many number of classes you are using in your custom data set. So these are the changes you have to do in your Pascal Vogue underscore 2007.py file, which is under datasets folder, right? Which is under datasets folder. Again, you can see we have, let's go back to our code, and you can see under datasets folder we have this file. You have to make changes in this file. Okay, all right. So now once you make changes in this file, next step is to open the pascalvoc_common.py file. You have to do few changes in this file also. Now let's open this file, pascalvoc_common. So this is the file. So in this file, you inside this voc_labels variable, you have to mention your label name. So these are the two labels we are using. So I've mentioned it. Obviously, again, you have to do the changes according to your data set over here. That's it, guys. In this file, you have to do this much only. Now, after that, the next step is, train your algorithm. Now we will train our algorithm using this command. First of all, which code is training, which file is training our algorithm? We have one file with the name of train_ssd_network.py. Let's open this file and see what is there. So we are opening this train_ssd_network.py file. So guys, here you can see, okay, just scroll down. Under these flags, you can see inside where we have this in general flags, train_dir. Over here, you have to change the path according to your computer. So this is according to my PC. So what I'm saying is, I want to have a log folder inside my current working directory. And in this folder, see, whatever path you'll write over here, in that particular location, your once you train your algorithm, that trained model will get stored at this particular location. Okay, so you have to do changes here. All right, and after that, just scroll down. Okay, keep on scrolling. Let me search. So let's search. Yes, classes. So under dataset flags, inside this num classes, where you have your num classes, here you need to define how many classes you want to use. Okay, and after that, search for batch. Yes, search for this batch size. By default, over here, earlier it was 32, right? I started with batch size 32, but 32 was not working for my code. I was getting memory issues, so I have changed the batch size to 6. Let's say if you are getting error with batch size 6 also, then you can change your batch size to 2, right? So you can change the batch size from here. So guys, even in my next video, I'll show you how to train your single shot detector model on Google Colab also. Let's say because there are some students, those who are those who don't have right resources to execute this code, so I'll show you on Google Colab also in my next video. I'll show you how to execute this whole code on Google Colab. Okay, so these are the changes you have to make in this train SSD network file. All right, so guys, after doing all these changes, what you need to do is, you just need to run this, just copy this command. I'll mention this, I have mentioned this command in my GitHub repo. Just copy this command from there, and where we were working, okay, so we are working over here. So as I've just told you, so this is the environment in which I'm working, and we are right now in our current working directory where I'm showing you my code. Just paste that code over here and press enter. The training process will get start. So my training is already started. Let me show you the training. So you can see this is the command right now which we are running and training is going on. So why I'm showing you this training, like if you have done all the steps properly, then your training will start, and obviously training will take time. So I've just prepared this example 2 hours back only. So from last 2 hours the training process is going on. So okay, let me show you the logs folder where we can see our performance. So let's open the log folder. Okay, not this one, I'm trying on some different folder. So this is here, I'm inside a log folder. Once you start the training, and if your training is going in a right way, you'll get one log folder. Inside this log folder you will start getting your model, right? So once your training will get completed, we'll use the model from this folder and we'll perform the testing. Okay, so if you want this, we can test it after our whole training get completed. So guys, we cannot test it right now. So now in my next video I'll show you how to use single shot detector model on Google Colab.